Hi, okay, so now we are discussing about fate of xenobiotic. Even last class we have discussed about xenobiotic, what exactly is xenobiotic, and then what is the fate, both environment also human being we have discussed. When we talk about little more deeper, if you see related to human being, so when we talk about the fate, so already we discussed, it's three different way it is entering to the body: ingestion and inhalation and thermal penetration. These three different way it is entering into the body, and also it is absorbed into the blood streams, and then further it will be distributed all over the body, tissues and organs. So after these process happen, as I told, they have three different way of fate is there. One is storage, other one is it makes a toxic action, other one is it make leads to some conversion of biotransformation and further conjugation process, and it will be excreted if it is going through this process. If some changes happening, it obviously it will be excreted from the body. Okay. So today we'll see little more extra detail in this process. Okay, so see, when we talk about the health, I'm saying toxic effect, I told, right? So what are the toxic effect, known very common toxic effects happening? It can, you know, affect all the systems. Even I told in the previous slide also, it's a carcinogenous, you know, it makes a cancer. It's very common liver cancer and melanoma. Why? Because of the liver cancer, most of the toxic compound will be processed by liver. So that is affect the liver and makes a cancer. And also it can suppress the immune system, and also it can swollen thymus gland. In infants, because they are not used to it with this kind of toxic xenobiotics, so they can also makes a problems in the immune system, and also it is makes nervous system also will be neurological functions can affect the infant, and also even it makes short term memory loss, and then the, you know, function of that nervous system will be, you know, takes time to do things, and this is very common reproductive system common effect because of these kind of xenobiotic. So reduced birth weight, and even decreases in gestational age. I'm saying the growth of the child, it won't be that good. And then even the many times abortions also very common due to this kind of xenobiotics. Even it can affect endocrine system. Other health effects we talk about, like respiratory health problems and injury of cells. So many other health effect also can happen because of the xenobiotics. So when we talk about how the detoxification of xenobiotics happening, so even we can separate them into two phases, phase 1 and phase 2. What is phase 1 and phase 2 detoxification process in the human body? For example, so when this three different way of entry into the body, so the phase 1 we need to talk about their reduction, oxidation, hydroxylation, hydrolysis. These four different process happening in our body. Due to this phase 1 reactions, primary metabolites will be produced. Whatever the end product of these reduction, oxidation, hydroxylation, hydrolysis, the primary metabolites will be formed. from the use of primary metabolites, further it will be go to phase 2 reactions. The phase 2 reactions are conjugation, sulfation, addition of sulfate, and methylation and glucuronization. Okay. So these finally the second, if it is come to secondary metabolite stage, so that will be again it will be, so this metabolites it's suitable for excretion process. So this is what we talking about. First process, it is a biotransformation process. After that, phase 2 reaction will happen. So if it is, once it has happened, then you know, finally it will be excreted from the body. Okay, so we'll see little more information about this the phase 1 and phase 2 reaction, little more info. But anyway, we are more concentrated on environmental aspect only, but still I want to give some small glimpse of what's happening in the human body also. For that reason, we have going little more information about this phase 1 and phase 2 reaction in the human being. Okay, so next slide. So first process, oxidation. See, oxidation, we talking about, as you people know, what is oxidation? Oxidation means addition of oxygen into the reaction or material. So because of this issue, even the nature of the xenobiotic compound will completely change. I'm saying if it is lipophilic nature, means it will be changed into hydrophilic nature. For example, here we talk about people are drinking a lot of ethanol. What exactly happened to the ethanol? It is simply because of the oxidation process, it is converted into acetic acid. Methanol into formic acid, and benzaldehyde, it is benzoic acid. Similar way, these the drugs, I'm saying xenobiotics, alcohol, aldehyde, amines, and drugs, they are all go through this oxidation process. This oxidation leads to some byproduct. This is what I'm saying, metabolites from the ethanol. And then methanol from formic acid. This kind of process happening in our body. So this process called oxidation. Oxidation means loss of electron. Maybe you people have heard about loss of electron. And then this is what happening when this oxidation process happens. Okay. So when you go to the next process, hydrolysis. Hydroxylation. Okay, hydroxylation process. So even this oxidation process, mostly important enzymes involved with the oxidation process, it's a monooxygenase enzyme, or even it is commonly called cytochrome 450. This is a very important component. So this is the one is detoxifies so many xenobiotic compounds in our body. So this is will be catalyzed by cytochrome 450 monooxygenase. So the many reactions of cytochrome 450 involve in addition of hydroxyl group, okay, to the xenobiotic. So because of the addition of hydroxyl group, that is process called hydroxylation. Because addition of hydroxyl group, it is called hydroxylation process. So hydroxylation, it is with the help of cytochrome 450 happening. So what I mean by hydroxylation, I already told, addition of hydroxyl group, OH, addition of hydroxyl group into the component. So whatever the xenobiotic compound, the addition of hydroxyl group will make them non-toxic in nature, or reduce the toxicity nature of the xenobiotic compound. It is happening. So from the reduced cytochrome 450 to oxidized cytochrome 450 happening. Okay, so this hydroxylation, okay, is also one type of oxidation process, because the oxidation happening. So here it is reduced to form with the help of oxygen, and then enzymatic reactions happening to form a oxidized form of cytochrome 450, and plus water it is forming. Okay, so this is one of the detoxification process of xenobiotic. So the cytochrome 450 is making a detoxification process by hydrolation process. See, this is structure. When you see the structure of the cytochrome 450, this is what I'm saying, it's happening. Even as you people know, cytochrome P, most of the organisms are present, even if bacteria, fungi, human being, all the organism, the cytochrome B is present. Okay, so the addition of the help of oxygen with the help of an energy molecule, NADPH, so the hydrolation process happening. Okay, so this is about hydroxylation process by cytochrome 450. So similar kind of hydroxylation process, it can happen with different xenobiotic compounds. Examples are given. Okay, phenobarbital through cytochrome 450, hydroxy phenobarbital is happening. The hydroxyl group is added to the xenobiotic compound. Okay, so because of this addition of hydroxyl group, the toxicity nature of the xenobiotic compound, it is getting reduced. So next process is a reduction process. So detoxification of xenobiotic by reduction process. So how this is, it is very less common and is less important than the oxidation, because oxidation and then hydroxylation process is very common, but this reduction process is very, less common when you consider. So the reduction process, what exactly happening? For example, the picric acid, okay, it is reduced and forms picromic acid. Similar way, this is a sedative one, chloral hydrate, this is very common sedative. The reduction, through the reduction process, it changing into trichloroethyl alcohol. Okay, so this similar kind of reduction process also happening. So one way or other way, if it's oxidation or a reduction process, obviously the toxicity of xenobiotic is reduced. That is the main take home from this reduction process also. So next process, hydrolysis. Okay, so these process is very common, and then it is many drugs detoxified by hydrolysis process. So hydrolysis means addition of water. That is what happening. For example, one a very very common drug, aspirin. For example, when people take aspirin, what exactly happened to this aspirin? After that, the hydrolysis process happened. Then the breakdown of components salicylic acid and acetic acid, separation will happen. This with the help of esterase enzyme. So this is a hydrolysis process. So atropine, that's one more tropic acid and tropine. This breakdown of material will happen when addition of water to the reaction. So this is called hydrolysis process. So when we are now actually we are talking about phase 1 detoxification process. One is a reduction, hydroxylation, and then oxidation, and then hydrolysis. These are all the process of detoxification process of xenobiotic. So next level, phase 2. Phase 2 detoxification process, the first one is a conjugation. Okay, phase 1, it's a 4 different process. One is oxidation, hydroxylation, and then reduction and hydrolysis. These 4 different processes happening to this is a process of detoxification of xenobiotic. So phase 2, when you talk about, so these are all the derivatives. For example, glucuronic acid, that's a derivative from the primary metabolites produced from phase 1 activity. So that will be further detoxified by conjugation process. Conjugation process means maybe you people studied in microbiology. That is what exactly happening combination of one more product. Okay, chemical combination of one or more compound with another compound. That is what conjugation process. The addition of one more component happening. So which are the xenobiotics are glucuronic acid, glutathione, and sulfate, glycination. So these kind of compounds will be added. Okay, added to the xenobiotic compound to make less toxic, or it will be excretable form, to change the xenobiotic into excretable form. Okay, conjugation process. So first one, when you glucuronic conjugation with the glucuronic acid, one of the conjugation process. See, for example, UDB glucuronate, so one of the compound, I'm saying intermediate compound, it is further it will be detoxified, and it will be excreted through the bile or urine. Okay, so bile or urine. So how this is happening, I'm saying UDP means uridine diphosphate glucuronate. So this process happening, the conjugation process, the glucuronic acid will be combined with this UDP glucuronate and finally form a glucuronide. So this will be easy to hydrophobic in nature, is easy to excreted from our body. So what I'm trying to say, it's a conjugation, it is a process, a combination of two components represent important. This is one of the biochemical mechanism attenuating the xenobiotic toxicity. Okay, so reduce the xenobiotic toxicity and facilitating the excretion of hydrophobic chemicals. So this is a conjugation with the glucuronic acid. So next, when you talk about benzoic acid with the glucuronic acid, the byproduct will come. Okay, conjugated benzoyl glucuronate will form, and then UDP will be separated. Even the paracetamol, very common drug what we using, that is also we mix a conjugation with the glucuronic acid, and then that will be excreted from our body. So some other drugs also, there are so many drugs they going through this conjugation process, and then will be excreted from our body. Even conjugation with the glycine, similar way, like benzoid, it's a more toxic one. That is also finally it is changed into hippuric acid, less toxic form by using the glycine. Similar way, glutathione also formed benzene. It is a carcinogen actually. This carcinogen will be glutathione, which is helping with glutathione transferase enzyme. They makes a conjugated product. That conjugated product, I'm saying, it's a mercaptoric acid. This mercaptoric acid, it is not a carcinogen. That will be excreted from the urine, through the urine. So the conjugation process happening with so many, glucuronic acid, glycine, or glutathione, these are all the things happening to reduce the toxicity of a xenobiotic compound. I think up to now it is enough for the basic process of xenobiotic compounds, what's happening in the human being. So what we discussed today, the xenobiotics, we know what is the fate of xenobiotics happening in our body. So when it is inside our body, biotransformation and conjugation process happening. Biotransformation process, I told four different process. One is oxidation, reduction process, and hydrolation process, and one more like hydrolysis process. So the phase one, I'm saying xenobiotic compound, okay, so they go through phase one and phase two. So then in this one, phase two, the conjugation is a very important process. Conjugation of different molecule, I'm saying sulfation, methyl compound, and glucuronation. All the process happens in phase two reactions, and finally it will be the xenobiotic compound will be excreted and go out of the body. That's all for basic information about detoxification of xenobiotic compound in human body.